Basically, first-class functions and lambdas are now supported. Arrays can now be typed, syntax for set get changed a bit, yield is now await, signals look a bit different, expert in some other keywords got a little mouse in front of them. I'll talk about them in detail in the following section. This video references an article from gdscript.com, link in the description, as well as official docs and my own code. Let's talk about first-class function. I'll make a function gt_5. I'll call filter on this array here, passing the function gt_5. As you can see, the resulting array only has numbers that are greater than 5. This gt_5 function is used only once ever in the entire script. For this, you might want to use lambda, func parentheses input colon output. This is all fine unless our array has some text in it. To make sure our array only has integers in it, you can type the array like so. In Godot 3, you use the setget keyword, and you have to write up a function somewhere else and put the function name in there. In Godot 4, add a colon. You would need an extra colon if you also explicitly type the variable. Notice that you are overriding the default behavior. Remember to assign the variable for the set function. Yield has been replaced with await and you no longer need the parentheses. I will elaborate on signals soon. Probably most useful for you right now is how to set up a little timer. It always bugged me that using signals involved strings, which what if I get a typo? Now these are done with signal objects. The function passed to connect gets called when the event happens. Hey look, first class function. This can be combined with lambda to create very concise and readable statements. Check out this segment from my work in progress project. Lastly, some keywords now have a little at symbol in front of them. Here are all of them. Check out the docs for details, link in the description. Have fun, make games.